More than 36 hours after a stunning silence over AAP Rajya Sabha MP Swati Baliwal's assault claim, the Aam Aadmi Party finally responded. While addressing a press conference, Sanjay Singh, who's also a Rajya Sabha MP from the party, stated that a condemnable incident took place on Monday. After Swati Maliwal reached Arvind Kejriwal's house in the morning, she was waiting in the drawing room. Bibab Kumar, the PA of the CM, came there and misbehaved and acted indecently with her. Aam Aadmi Party says the Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal has taken cognizance of the entire incident and has directed that strict action be taken. But we haven't heard so far what that action is going to be. This afternoon, Sanjay Singh met Swati Maliwal at her residence. It seems obvious that there are attempts to placate her. This after she had called police on Monday morning, alleging that she'd been physically beaten at the Chief Minister's house by his PA at the former's behest. Mind you, this is a sitting Rajya Sabha female MP and the Chief Minister of the Delhi government we are talking about. An unparalleled such case that has come to light. Delhi BJP, of course, has staged a protest outside the CM's residence demanding police probe. What message does it send that the Chief Minister himself is quiet, even though this happened by their own admission at his residence, by his own man? Why is he promising any action at a personal level? Why not just support Swati Baliwal in filing a police complaint? Concerning issue is that Swati herself has remained silent so far. Is there an attempt to settle the matter internally? That's the big question we take to our guests in just a bit. Now, while Aam Aadmi Party has accepted that there was an incident, their version is dramatically different than what the police note recorded after Swati Maliwal's call. So the police note says that the caller says that I have been badly beaten and this has happened at the Chief Minister's residence. The Aam Aadmi Party's version only says that the CM's PA misbehaved with her. Now, misbehavior can be a lot of things. It can be verbal or physical. They added that there was indecent behavior. Again, that can mean a lot of things. It's not neither here nor there. The police note also recorded that the PA acted at Chief Minister's instructions. That is what the caller has said, that the PA beat her at the CM's insistence. Now, the Aam Aadmi Party's version says that the CM has taken cognizance and has directed action. So, there is a mismatch as far as the role of the Chief Minister here is concerned. Now, the way Swati has gone quiet and the Aam Aadmi Party is openly trying to placate her has left many big questions in everyone's mind. Firstly, of course, everything hinges on Swati's complaint. Why has she not filed one yet? What is really going on? As former DCW head, she was vocal on women taking action, particularly against such things, but herself, she is quiet. Why did it take Aam Aadmi Party so long to respond to this incident, to what has happened? It took them a while to figure out what they want to say. Was it mere misbehavior, as I said, as the Aam Aadmi Party is suggesting, or some physical assault, as the Swati's call record suggests? Isn't it odd that Aam Aadmi Party is coming out to say that the Chief Minister has directed action? What value does that have? Who is he to direct any action but for the fact that there needs to be a police complaint and then police probe in this matter? Nothing else can really happen. Nothing else should suffice. Even if they are planning action, let's say internally as a party on Bibab Kumar, why haven't we heard anything of what that action is? It's taking pretty long. Instead, parleys are going on in the national capital. The biggest question is, why is Aam Aadmi Party not encouraging Swati Maliwal to file a complaint instead of trying to settle this? Is this their stand on how such cases should be handled? That leads us to the big debate coming up. With this case or alleged physical assault, is there some attempt going on to settle the matter internally? And how is this going to reflect on all sides?
स्वाति मालीवाल जी के साथ बहुत बदतमीजी की, अभद्रता की, इस घटना की जितनी निंदा की जाए कम है।
राष्ट्रपति को बोलना चाहिए, बताना चाहिए कि कुछ राज्यसभा वगैरह कुछ नहीं है, बहुत बड़ी साजिश है और इसकी जान को भी खतरा है।
अभी तक आम आदमी पार्टी ने केवल निंदा करी है, अरविंद केजरीवाल जी ने अभी कोई कार्रवाई क्यों नहीं करी?
Let's go across to our guest joining us. Anuja Kapoor is spokesperson Delhi BJP with us. The Aam Aadmi Party has not joined the show. Ravi Srivastav is a political analyst, backs the Aam Aadmi Party on most issues. Rukmani Singh is lawyer and Uma Sisodia is an activist, all joining us on the show. I do thank you for your time. Ravi Srivastav, let me begin with you. How does it look that this incident admittedly happened at the Chief Minister's residence? They're calling it indecent and condemnable incident that happened, misbehavior. But they're also trying to settle this internally. Shouldn't the Chief Minister be the first one to say that nothing doing, go file a complaint and we are with you? What are they trying to achieve here?
Good evening, Shivani. First of all, I am hearing a narrative is being created, so the assault gate or something like that. I think there was no assault at all.
You think so? Why?
No, it is because the Aam Aadmi Party themselves in the press conference did not mention about any assault.
Exactly. But the police note mentions assault.
No, police note is written by some 8th fail constable who has written 2 versions there, which is correct. Who knows that? What she understood?
So you're saying we should not trust the police version at all?
Absolutely not. First of all, the police version should not be leaked to the media.
Because why not? Why should the media not know about this? Just because it concerns the Aam Aadmi Party?
It has got no evidential value.
That's not what I'm saying. Why should we not know about this? Why are you so uncomfortable about the media knowing about this?
I'm not uncomfortable.
No, so answer my question.
I'm answering you the question.
No, my question is, the Chief Minister's responsibility here is what? It happened by their own admission. And forget assault. If let's say we assume it's not an assault, it's indecent behavior, inappropriate behavior, and condemnable misbehavior. Now this happened at the Chief Minister's residence. What should his responsibility be?
The Chief Minister's residence has got at least 500 CCTV cameras.
Hmm.
Everything will be established.
Sure.
And as regards Chief Minister's action time, I don't know. It is up to him. He is a Chief Minister. He has got many other commitments. He will take the action in due course.
He can't perform any Chief Ministerial duties. Do you know the irony right now? He's out on bail and he cannot perform any Chief Ministerial duties. So I'm wondering what else he's doing.
No, Chief Minister duties of signing files. That's all.
What else is there?
He is a Chief Minister.
He can't attend anything.
He is a sitting chief. He cannot attend his office, right?
Yeah.
I'm not denying that.
Yeah.
What I'm saying, why the BJP has got... Why the BJP has got so much of love and affection?
You brought the BJP in. One second. Now, I want the viewers to know this. No, one second.
You want only answers to your questions.
Of course. How else does this work?
I cannot question you. I can question you too.
I don't know. You're twisting the entire format. One second. Ravi Srivastav, I'll give you time. But let's not escape. One second. Ravi Srivastav, let's not try to escape the inescapable questions here. You are saying there are CCTV cameras available at the Chief Minister's residence. Sure enough, everything will be, can be made plain in the next 2 hours, if that's the need. The requirement here from the Chief Minister's office or the Chief Minister or the party should be to say ki hum action lenge, or should be to say ki we encourage Swati Maniwal to go to the police, file a complaint, we are with her, we know what happened and we want action to be taken on this. I am simply on this point. Why are they trying to settle this internally?
This is party's issue.
No, it's not. It's a legal issue. It's a criminal issue. It's not a party issue.
Show me the legality there.
The legality is that a PCR call was made. A woman is alleging she was badly beaten at the Chief Minister's residence. You don't find that a problem?
No, not at all.
It's not a problem.
Because she went to the police station. If she was manhandled, there would have been evidence. she would have filed a complaint there.
No, that's a separate question. Are you saying the fact that the chief minister's office, the Aam Aadmi Party is accepting that something happened with Swati Maliwal at the chief minister's residence?
It is indecent behavior and misbehavior. That is all.
So that doesn't require a criminal complaint?
That does require an action internally.
No criminal complaint.
No, police complaint is not there, and that's what I'm telling you.
Should there be?
Why should we coach anybody? She is not a kid, a school-going kid, kindergarten.
No, she you have opinions woman. On everything. Should Swati Maliwal file a complaint or not?
Who are you or me to guide her?
What do you think? Should she file a complaint or not? Indecent behavior at Chief Minister's residence. Are you saying this should be settled and rafa dafa kar do internally?
Later she would have found it is not worth complaining, that's all. Who are we to guide her?
Okay.
I mean, that's none of our
business. So indecent behavior happened by Aam Aadmi Party's admission at the Chief Minister's residence against a sitting Rajya Sabha MP, and you are saying there's no need for a criminal complaint.
I am saying, who are we to guide? She knows the law.
No, but what should she be the chief minister's stand here?
No, why the chief? You are again bringing chief minister.
It happened at his residence, no?
The residence is one thing, but chief minister was there. Who proved it?
No, I'm not saying that. Let that be proven. But there has to be a police probe to prove anything.
No, but police, she went to the police, no? She went to the police station. Nobody asked for any manhandling. There was no medico-legal case. No medical examination happened. No complaint filed. She has not said anything 48 hours since then. Who are we to guide her? And why should we guide her?
Okay, why should we guide her? Why should anybody care? Anuja Kapoor, why should anybody care? She is not filing a complaint.
If Anuja Kapoor is to be questioned, she should be questioned for Manipur, where our Prime Minister has...
I'm not going to do whataboutry. No, Ravi Srivastava, I don't allow that on my show. When I discuss Manipur, I discuss Manipur. When I discuss Prajwal Revana, I discuss Prajwal Revana. When I discuss Brij Bhushan case, I discuss Brij Bhushan case. Please don't speak over me or the other guests. And I will not allow whataboutry. I'm making that absolutely clear. On cases like this, it is absolutely abominable to do any kind of whataboutry. Anuja Kapoor, why should anybody care if the prime concerned, the so-called complainant, who should be the complainant or the person who called the police, allegedly, is not coming forward? What else can anybody else do?
Jai Shri Ram, I think the whole case rests in peace, because right now, we just see a political analyst of just who backs up. So we do not see an official spokesperson sitting here who should be talking about it. So I think from here onwards, a BJP spokesperson is speaking to a political analyst. So that is why, because they believed what they have done, because they have not sent an official spokesperson to put forward their stand. So this already puts in the perspective where the Aam Aadmi Party used to say just 1 or 2 days back that the BJP is trying to allegate or bringing up Swati Maliwal's case, which is not in the way it has been looked. Now the sitting Rajya Sabha, Sanjay Singh, who is an MP, has done a press conference and spoke in the favor of his colleague, who is again a Rajya Sabha MP, and telling what Arvind Kejriwal has done. Arvind Kejriwal is a gunda who has done it in his gunda raj.
No, he's not said that. He's not said that. No, one second. Anuja, he's not said that at all. No, one second. Ravi Srivastava, just put his fader down, please. I don't want people speaking over each other, please.
There is no point.
Anuja, one second, make your point.
Listen to you, Shivani.
No, one second, Anuja, make your point.
He is a gunda. No, he is a gunda. I will not stop on this.
No, don't claim that Sanjay Singh has said that. Sanjay Singh has not said any such thing. Sanjay Singh has said that this an incident happened which is highly condemnable, and the CM has directed action. Now, what that action is, I don't know. Let the Aam Aadmi Party explain that.
Shivani, allow me to speak. Please.
Don't misquote Sanjay Singh. No, Anuja, I can't allow that. I'm sorry.
What I said, I am only saying that. Fine. Gunda. That Sanjay Singh has not said it.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, Sanjay Singh has just said that in his press conference that the assault has happened with Swati Maliwal in presence of Arvind Kejriwal, and Vibhav has done it. What I am saying is Arvind Kejriwal is a gunda. BJP is saying this. And I'm also saying that he is in his house. In first time, sometime back, in 20th February 2018, Delhi Chief Secretary also alleged assault, which happened in presence of Arvind Kejriwal by the two MLAs. His name is Anshu Prakash. This case was also been put up. Was he sleeping at that time, Arvind Kejriwal? Now, this is the second case which has been happening.
No, so the question that is being asked, Anuja, the question that is being asked is, what is the police supposed to do in this? What is anybody supposed to do in this? If Swati Maliwal doesn't come forward herself.
NCW has already sent an inquiring team. They are already sending it to look into the matter. The president of NCW has also given a formal letter to the Delhi police to send an ATR in the matter. So this has also been done. This is what an NCW would have done, could have taken the cognizance. I would also like to ask, what is it that Arvind Kejriwal was so scared of Swati Maliwal that he started beating her? He asked her to do that. The people, the Vaibhav Kumar did that. Why? Because she did not support him. She was outside India when Arvind Kejriwal is there. There is also an alleged thing which is also coming up in the market, in the news, is that there is some problem with Abhishek Manu Singhvi. Is there also some case of that? So where her husband, do you think Naveen Jayhind is also cooking up the stuff? And his husband is also cooking up the stuff, and he also said that her life is in danger.
The complainant in this case could do. Anuja, one second. I want to go across to Rukmini Singh as well. You're a lawyer and an activist. There really needs to be some sort of atmosphere created, in the sense that there needs to be an enabling atmosphere if Swati Maliwal needs to be able to file a complaint. Now, of course, she is not someone who needs much guidance. She's headed the DCW herself. She would have guided many women in similar situations. But it is a little odd that despite being, the fierce woman that she is, she's quiet for 48 plus hours now.
So thank you for having me, Shivani. 13th May, two calls were made to Delhi police from CM residence of physical assault by Swati Maliwal. And post that, she went to the police station, never filed any complaint, came back. So there is no written complaint about this. The Delhi police can investigate the matter, go to CM's house. I'm sure, as the Aam Aadmi Party spokesperson said, there are enough CCTV cameras.
But can they? Can they do so, suo motu?
They can do this suo motu. They can do this suo motu. Take CCTV footages and investigate the matter further. She is alleging Vibhav Kumar, who is the henchman of Arvind Kejriwal, of physically beating her. And it's very shocking that she's been missing since then.
Yes.
She and her ex-husband also is saying that her life is in danger. She's also quiet. So it's very shocking that if lawmakers and ex-DCW chief are unsafe in CM house, I can't comment on the safety of common women of our city.
No, it's not that. It's not just about safety. It's about the fact... it's happening inside the chief minister's residence. It has been accepted. And look how how everyone around her is acting. They're saying,
other workers. What will be the conduct of the party's MLA if Kejriwal's PA is doing such act? What will be the conduct of the party's MLA and other workers? She has been silent since last 48 hours, missing. Maybe she's being threatened. Maybe she's being asked to keep quiet because of the ongoing elections by the CM and his party workers. So anything can happen. And Uma, knowing how courageous, how fierce she is, I'm definitely sure that she is being sidelined and being threatened. So her life is in danger. So definitely this needs to be investigated, and it's something very serious.
Uma Sisodia, if you were to put, if you were to just change the party concerned here, I can only imagine the kind of outrage that would have followed by the same people who are conveniently quiet today. From the chief minister, Aam Aadmi Party leader Arvind Kejriwal, to, let's say, any other India Alliance party chief who don't want to look at this, that a woman sitting Rajya Sabha MP was assaulted inside the chief minister's residence, and everybody is acting like let's just have life go on like nothing has happened. Ma'am, can you unmute yourself? Yes, Uma Sisodia, can you hear me? Go ahead.
Yes, I can hear and I can answer you. अभी मैंने आप सभी लोगों की बातचीत सुनी है और मैं बहुत हैरान हूं कि इस केस को लेकर जिसमें कि स्वाति मालीवाल जी ने अभी अपनी तरफ से कोई कंप्लेंट दर्ज नहीं कराई है, उन्होंने कोई एक्शन नहीं लिया है और जिस तरीके से इसको मुद्दा बनाया जा रहा है देश के बाकी तमाम दिल्ली के बाकी तमाम मुद्दों को छोड़कर, जिस तरीके से चुनाव के टाइम बीजेपी इसको लगातार मीडिया के माध्यम से, अखबारों के माध्यम से, प्रोटेस्ट के माध्यम से मुद्दा बना रही है, इससे बहुत बेहतर होता कि आप लोग पुलिस में जाते और आप लोग वहां पर कंप्लेंट दर्ज कराते कि राज्यसभा सांसद के खिलाफ ऐसा ऐसा हो गया है, वो बोल नहीं रही है, आप हमारी कंप्लेंट लिखिए और इस पर जांच कीजिए, तब मुझे लगता है कि ये चीजें ज्यादा सही होती।
क्यों सीएम क्यों नहीं करवाते कंप्लेंट? सीएम के घर में हुआ है, उनको पता है, सीएम क्यों नहीं करवाते कंप्लेंट? हम क्यों करवाएं?
अरे आप बहस आप कर रहे हैं, सीएम थोड़ी बहस कर
हमारा काम है, हम तो हर इशू का बहस करते हैं, उसमें क्या लेना देना है? इसका मतलब ये थोड़ा ना कि हम मीडिया वाले जाके हर किसी केस में कंप्लेंट कराएंगे, ये क्या लॉजिक
है? देश की राजधानी में इतना बड़ा कांड हो गया,
नहीं सीएम के घर में हुआ है, इतना बड़ा कांड सीएम के घर में हुआ है, आप कह रहे सीएम की रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी नहीं है, आप कह रहे डिस्कस मत करो,
राजनीति हो रही है, सिर्फ और सिर्फ राजनीति हो रही है,
तो राजनीति नहीं होगी ना, पुलिस प्रोब हो जाने दीजिए, चीफ मिनिस्टर कंप्लेंट रजिस्टर करा दे, पुलिस प्रोब हो जाए, फिर राजनीति नहीं होगी।
दिल्ली में आप ये नहीं कह सकते कि वहां पर दिल्ली में केजरीवाल जी की पुलिस है वो हमारी बात नहीं सुन रही है, आप नहीं कह सकते दिल्ली में बीजेपी की पुलिस है, सेंटर की पुलिस है, अगर सेंटर इतना कमजोर हो गया कि एक राज्यसभा के सांसद को कंप्लेंट नहीं लिखवा पा रहा है तो मैं हैरान हूँ सेंटर पर, आप जाके वहां पे कंप्लेंट क्यों नहीं दर्ज करा?
नाउ दिल्ली पुलिस शुड गेट हर टू फाइल अ कंप्लेंट, बट द मैन हु इज द चीफ मिनिस्टर ऑफ दिल्ली, हिज हाउस दिस असॉल्ट टू प्लेस हैज नो रिस्पांसिबिलिटी।
अगर इतना बड़ा कांड केजरीवाल जी के घर पर हो गया है तो दिल्ली पुलिस को सोतो मोटो इसको लेना चाहिए, कंप्लेंट दर्ज कराने चाहिए और जाकर पूरी तरह जांच करनी चाहिए, उन जांच में जो एविडेंसेस आए उन पर हम लोग बैठकर यहां बहस कर सकते हैं।
नहीं तो आम आदमी पार्टी ने तो मान लिया है कि इंसिडेंट हुआ है, उनकी क्या जिम्मेदारी बनती है मैम?
देखिए मैं कह रही हूँ ना, आज आपके टीवी डिबेट को देखकर यहाँ पे बीजेपी की स्पोक पर्सन भी बैठी हुई है, लॉयर खुद आपके साथ है, आप लोग जाइए और पुलिस में वाकई में आपको कंप्लेंट कराने चाहिए, आप लोगों को एक उदाहरण पेश करना चाहिए कि देखिए हम कितना अपनी महिलाओं की सुरक्षा के लिए हम कितना।
सो द ओनर्स ऑफ हु फाइल्स द कंप्लेंट नाउ हैज बीन कंप्लीटली शिफ्टेड, दिस इज द फर्स्ट टाइम यू विल हियर सच एन आर्ग्यूमेंट, मे बी बिकॉज देयर इज पॉलिटिक्स इन्वॉल्वड एंड पॉलिटिक्स इज गोइंग ऑन दिस केस। आई रन आउट ऑफ टाइम, आई डू thank our guests for joining us.